And America is the most advanced country. But let me tell you the secret. America is the most unhappy country in the world. America has the largest number of illnesses. And America has the shortest life expectancy among the industrialized countries. And America has the costliest medical system. And America has the maximum number of illnesses and least number of well people. As a matter of fact, there is no well monsters at all. But technology interface, industry education interface was a big thing in the West about 20 years ago. Universities were very happy because they were getting a lot of money because industry has money. And they built centers of marriage between the industry and the interface. This was a love marriage to begin with. There was no arrangement. Very soon the marriage fell out. Because one student in Harvard was sitting in the class and the professor was preaching something on something, A, B, C, D. Let's not go into the details. And the student was so confused. So student got up and said, "Sir, you're talking like an industry representative and you're not talking like a scientist. What will happen to a student who gets up and tells a very distinguished professor that you're talking through your hat? What will happen to him in your colleges? He'll become an outstanding student." Right? That's what happened to Werner Heisenberg in 1925 in the Zurich Polytechnic. Einstein was going eloquent on E is equal to mc squared. And then this boy said, "Sir, you're talking through your hat." So Werner Heisenberg became an outstanding student of physics for 30 years. And he got his Nobel Prize for his uncertainty principle, probably is the only one principle which is certain in science, in 1956. So this boy said, "I am going to find out about this student," because this Harvard student, and he found out, to cut the long story short, that he found out this professor was on the payroll of the industry. He had 47,000 shares in the industry. He had received in the last 10 years $10 million for consultation, lecturing, and this and that, and what have you, what's called hospitality. And the professor lost his job. Then Harvard found out 48% of their professors are on the payroll of the industry. Yale, Princeton, you name it, they had it, except Penn State University. So student assessment of the universities, all these elite universities lost their A status. They came to C, B, D, F. Now what, let us keep education separate. Let's not mix up the two things. Let us have basic education to make a human being a human being. I change the Vedic saying, janmanaha jatuhu jantu, karmanaha jatuhu dvijaha. So janmanaha jatuhu jantu, vidya jatuhu manushaha. To make a man, you must have education. Then when once he is a graduate, okay, you teach him anything you like. IT man wants to teach him only IT. And another auto industry man might like only all people to be auto industrialized, etc., etc. Now as a doctor, I have a problem now. I have a new disease. It's called IT syndrome. I'm not joking. I'm very serious. Huh? I'm not joking. I have many young men and women who have problems when they're about 25, 30. By the time they're 30, they've already had high blood pressure, their diabetes, their hearts are not functioning normally, girls don't menstruate, they're very irregular, and everybody is diagnosed with some A, B, C, D label. What I found over the years was that this dirty electricity that comes, you know, you have this Wi-Fi in your house, in your room, 10 mobile phones charging all over the place, and you take one mobile phone and keep it there and talk to hours together, brain tumor is likely to come very soon. Cancers are on the rise. Everything is going up. And what is happening there? Rat race. Did you know that before money came into this world, there was no illness at all? I'm not joking. Yeah, I can't be joking it. ICTAC is a very important thing. I'm seriously telling you, I'll give you a reference. Failure of scientific medicine, the Innu community study. A paper in the Canadian Journal of Medical Education, 1962. What did the paper say? There was this group of people called Innus off the coast of Saskatchewan. They were aboriginal races in some islands. They had no touch with the reality of what we call a civilization, quote unquote. They had their own egalitarian society. They were hunter-gatherers. They had hunted, gathered things. They got fruits, etc. Distributed equally. There was nothing called I, mine, mine, mine. No, it is ours, we. See the two words? I means illness. We means wellness. We have now high-rise buildings, wide ways. But where do we live? We live in apartments, keeping people apart. When I was a little kid in a village, there were a few people in the village. Even if one mad had fever, the whole village will know. Today in your high-rise, multi-storied, high-tech building, the neighbor dies till the dead body starts smelling. You won't know. Why does the dead body smell? 500 species of germs in this universe start eating the every part of that body. Our ancestors were very scientific. That's why they made your shoes out of skin, because skin is the last part to be eaten up by these germs. So it lasts longer. But all the other muscle and all will be over in about weeks' time. And all that smell is emanated by the fungus that grows. And then only you say, somebody must have died somewhere in the vicinity, maybe in the same building or in the next building. This is not what we want for future. We want a little bit of understanding ourselves. Naan yaar, Ramana Maharshi wrote a beautiful book. Naan yaar. Who am I? Do you know who you are? And why are you here? You have not understood that. Education must teach you that. What are you here for? Our ingress into this world, wrote D.H. Lawrence, was naked and bare. Did you come with anything here? Even underwear you didn't have. Our progress in this world is trouble, but care for others. Our regress from this world will be nobody knows where. But if you do well here, you will do well there. So don't worry where you are going, heaven or hell. Both ways you are here happy, because if you went to heaven, that's where you wanted to go, artha, dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Supposing perchance you go to hell by mistake, not your mistake, God's account keeping mistake, which is not computerized yet. So what happens? What happens to you? You are in hell with so many of your friends. You are so happy. So, don't you worry about where you are going and what is going to happen. If you do well here, you will do well there. What do you do here? The next thing of healthy mind. What is that? Enthusiasm to be compassionate. You want happiness, do you? See that someone you give happiness. Happiness will come back. It's like a mirror. Wrote Christina, if love is what you give away, love is what comes back each day. If happiness is what you give away, happiness is what comes back each day. You think now IT advancement, America is the most advanced country. But let me tell you the secret. America is the most unhappy country in the world. America has the largest number of illnesses. And America has the shortest life expectancy among the industrialist countries. And America has the costliest medical system. And America has the maximum number of illnesses and least number of well people. As a matter of fact, there is no well monsters at all. An American professor wrote this beautiful book. Please read this, called The Last Well Person. The Last Well Person. The professor's name is Norton Hadler, who's professor in the Princeton University's medical school. Why? 14 countries, industrialized countries, study showed Japan with the least number of doctors per capita, vis-a-vis America with the largest number of doctors per capita, Japan with the least number of specialists, and America with almost 99.99% specialists, and America spending the maximum amount of money, Japan spending the least amount of money. Japan is the best country for health, longest longevity, and happiness-wise, they are the best. America is the worst. You don't believe me, right? Write down, read this article. Is US medicine the best in the world? What's the article's name? Is US medicine best in the world? Who wrote it? A professor in Johns Hopkins University. Her name is Barbara Starfield. And where is the article published? In the very most prestigious American journal called JAMA. Journal of the American Medical Association. Year is 2000. Volume 284. Page 483. Please read this. No, you should know the reality, right? Where is the reality? All that we're having is hype. You know what happens in any statement? Winston Churchill said it so beautifully. Our papers write various statements, our politicians make various statements, our leaders make various statements, and when I came here, they took me to a room called VIP room. I was afraid I missed a beat, because my concept of a VIP is very insignificant person. So I thought, and it proved to be right, because, you know, I was supposed to give a keynote address in the beginning, and I was almost being pushed off to an extent that I wanted to go away, and then the young man caught me and said, no, I will give you some time here, just talk. So again, I was reminded of what Winston Churchill said. In any statement, there are three important things. What are they? Who makes the statement? If he's somebody very, very big, it's a very important statement. How does he make the statement? If he makes it in a fashionable way, call the press and then talk about it, he's important. And what he says is the least important. So you have a lot of these statements made, but the reality is, with more money, more industry, more advancement, we have less health, more problems, and mankind is not happy today. In America, there are two diseases. Not heart attack and cancer, they have gone side. Suicide. And divorce. I know in Bangalore, they had ordinary courts, and I was talking to the lawyers. In an average, about 1,000 divorces in a year, in all the Bangalore courts. Now they have a divorce court in Bangalore, and every month they have got about 5,000 to 10,000 divorce cases being filed. So we are catching up with America. We are not bad. We have been aping America, but we are catching up with America. And frustration. When do you get frustration? When you don't have a healthy mind, you get frustration, because I want. Somebody, Shishya came to the Guru and said, I want peace, Swamiji. Swamiji said, repeat that. I want peace. Say that again without the I. Want peace. Say that without the want. Peace. See, there is peace. What disturbed peace? Want and I. So when you want, I want money, I want job, I want promotion, I want this, I want that, I want to be the president of India. And if you don't become, you get frustrated. And the next thing is suicide. Do you want this to happen? Do you want this country also to follow the American way? No, we must have our own. See, we have our own background. Modernity does not come from the United States of America or Britain or Europe. Modernity should come from your own antiquity. There's a beautiful saying. That doesn't mean just say India was great and sleep and eat nothing. No. India was great, but we have to modernize it. That's what, see, for example, modern Western medicine, which we think is the panacea for all modern human ills, has been mumbo-jumbo, sorcery and witchcraft 5,000 years ago in the Nile Valley. But it modernized itself. And that is where India has to modernize from its antiquity. I'll give you one example. We have hell of a lot of wonderful drugs for various diseases, but we don't bother about them for the simple reason that the industry from the West is selling it in a big way here, saying that ours is the only thing that for you. And what are they selling? Reductionist chemicals. When you put a reductionist chemical in the system, the system says, this is poison, reject it. And it's thrown into the liver for destruction. So every one of you, mark my words, every one of you, when you're taking any tablet, you go for have a liver function test done, your liver function test is damaged. And today we have a new disease, which is a huge disease called non-alcoholic cirrhosis. When I was a student 60 years ago, we never heard of anything other than alcohol as a cause of cirrhosis. Today, we don't have alcoholic cirrhosis at all, because there is an awareness about not drinking too much. Of course, they still drink. That's a different thing. But today, non-alcoholic cirrhosis, which kills people left, right, and center. And all this we don't think, because we think modernity comes from the West.